Praise the Lord, saints, and welcome back to FFT, Food for Thought Ministries, where we move with purpose and our walk with Christ over here. My name is Rokisha Muhammad, and welcome to my channel, to all my new subscribers. Welcome to all my day ones. Welcome back. Amen. This is our woman series entitled A Woman of Purpose and Power. We will be doing this until the duration of these 90 days are over. However, I am only posting these 3 days a week. Amen. And we are currently on day 9. Hallelujah. If this is your first video that you're clicking on today, I highly recommend you go back to day 1 because they do build upon each other. Amen. However, you do you. Amen. So without further ado, we're going to get into this devotion. I'm going to read it through one time. I'm going to leave you with a thought and the reading, and you will be on your own to sup with the Lord. Okay. He wants you to spend time with him during this time. This is the one-on-one with him that he wants you to spend with him. Amen. So let's get into it, ladies. All right. It says, to discover purpose, never ask the creation, ask the creator. My Lord. Again, to discover purpose, never ask the creation, ask the creator. And this is found in Isaiah chapter 64, verse 8. And it reads, yet you, Lord, are our Father. We are the clay. You are the potter. We are all the work of your hand, my Lord. And let's read that in the Amplified today. All right, this is my Amplified Study Bible, and we're going to read it really quickly. And it says, yet, O Lord, you are our Father, we are the clay, and you our potter, and we all are the work of your hand. My Lord, hallelujah. Amen. Are you allowing the Lord to mold you into his purpose, into what he wants you to become? Or are you going against the grain and forming yourself according to the ways of this world? Amen. Something to just ponder. Amen. All right, let's get into it, ladies. So it says, excuse me. We have seen that nobody knows a product and how it should work better than the one who made it. In the same way, the one who created the product is the best one to fix it when it has become marred. When a potter works on a pot and sees that it has a flaw in it, the potter either remolds the clay and starts over, or if the pot already has been fired in an oven, the potter has to smash it and start over. Now, when the clay starts talking back to the potter, something is wrong. See Isaiah 29 and 16. The potter knows better than the pot how the pot should be fashioned. The pot can't say to the potter, you shouldn't have made me this way, because the pot can't see the whole picture the way the potter can. When it comes to the relationship between male and females and society duration of women, we have too often murmured against the potter rather than trying to understand how and why we were created. Moreover, our substitutes for his master design are flawed. Some of us need to have our attitudes, perspectives, and lives remolded. A few of us have gone so far in the wrong direction that we may need a total overhaul, my Lord. God's principles are very serious and very awesome, but also very necessary for the restoration of humanity to God's purposes. Come on, somebody. All right. So if you want to discover the purpose of something, never ask the creation, ask the one who made it. The creation might not think it has any worth, but the creator knows what it was made of. Many people do not think they have any worth or purpose. Yet the first chapter of our manual tells us God saw all that he made and it was very good. Genesis 1 verses 31. There is something good in God's creation, no matter how confused it looks to us. There is something good about every person, even though it may be hard to find. There is something good about everything God has made. We need to go to him to find the good purpose for which he has made us. Quote, for it is God who works in you to will and to act in order to fulfill his good purpose. Philippians 2 and 13. And I'm going to leave you with this thought today. And it says, the one who created the product is the best one to fix it when it has become marred. That's flawed, broken, some type of affliction, okay? Marred. You're not in your whole perfect state. And your reading today is going to be coming from Jeremiah chapter 18. And you're going to be reading verses 1 through 6. Then you're going to jump on over to Philippians chapter 2. And you're going to be reading verses 12 through 16. And that is what you need to be meditating on today. If you are a journaler, then you want to journal these readings out and journal out this thought as your prompt. All right. And if not, and if you have the book, you can just write right here. Amen. If there's not enough room, then you can have a separate journal, of course. But make sure you write down all these scriptures and read them. Sup with the Lord, talk to him, ask questions. What is your purpose? Are you doing what you're supposed to be doing? Are you fulfilling his purpose in your life? Are you doing what he has called you to do? Amen. That's what this book is all about. This whole devotion is devotion. Yeah, this whole devotion is to find our purpose and our power. Amen. A woman purpose of power, purpose and power. Okay. So we are finding our purpose and we are finding our power as women. Hallelujah. So I hope this has blessed you today. Again, this is day 9. Let's keep it going, ladies. I love you all. Pray for me as I pray for you. Bye-bye now.